As we enter 2026 and pledge New Year's resolutions, nature may also take a hint to cause a change in various volcanoes this year, creating brand new volcanic eruptions. Thus, since it is the first day of 2026, you might wonder which volcanoes could theoretically erupt in the brand new year, which are not erupting at the present. Before I unveil my list of 5 volcanoes which could erupt in 2026, I want to note a disclaimer. This list is largely opinion-based, so do not take my entries on this list as fact, especially since not every volcano mentioned in my prior year's videos ended up erupting. Predicting which volcanoes may erupt in the long term is near impossible. What I discuss are merely educated guesses with 10 of 20 volcanoes I mentioned at the start of 2022 to 2025 ending up erupting that year, and there is no guarantee that this average success rate in my guesses will continue in 2026. For the third year in a row, and yes, I know the residents of Grindavik and Iceland won't necessarily feel too great hearing this, but in my opinion, the adjacent Reykjanes volcano is the most likely complex to erupt in 2025. Ever since late October of 2023, magma has been continuously recharging a 5-kilometer depth magma chamber about 1,100 meters south of the Sartsingi geothermal power plant, which, once filled, has fed multiple magmatic intrusions. While not all of these intrusions turned magma run events result in eruptions, magma does end up taking essentially the same pathway each time. While there is a notably diminished magma supply being input into the aforementioned magma chamber compared to 1 or 2 years ago, the same circumstances that led to the 9 prior eruptions are still present. Despite being 169 days and counting since the start of its last eruption, the Reykjanes volcano, in my opinion, once again appears to be in a stage where it could erupt at some point in the next month. Thus, it is possible that we see 1 or maybe even 2 more eruptions of the Reykjanes volcano during 2026. Heading to a remote but famous volcanic island in the Pacific, I also expect some form of volcanic eruption to occur on or close offshore of Iwo Jima. Since 2020, Iwo Jima has been undergoing an increased rate of uplift, causing the ground to rise by as much as 1.5 meters or 4.9 feet a year. This has been caused by the refilling of its magma chamber and since 2020 has led to at least one volcanic eruption every year. With a high rate of recent eruptions and the high rate of uplift linked to such still ongoing, this is why I claim Iwo Jima as the second most likely volcano to erupt in 2026. Heading off the coast of Oregon, I also expect the Axial Seamount volcano to erupt sometime this year. Now, I know what you are thinking. Axial Seamount was claimed to have a near certain chance of erupting in 2025, yet no eruption happened, despite the deemed 90% chance of such. However, Axial Seamount during its entire monitored history has consistently followed a nice predictable pattern, always erupting when its caldera floor is uplifted to about the same level as seen before its previous eruption began. This has occurred within 43 centimeters difference, a figure that on the upper end will be reached near the end of July 2026. Thus, in theory, Axial Seamount should erupt anytime before then, although I want to remind everyone that volcanoes are unpredictable systems and can sometimes throw a wrench into a highly predictable scientific model that previously worked well. Fourth on my list, I deem the Piton de la Fournaise shield volcano on France's Réunion Island to have a decent chance of erupting this year. This volcano has averaged an eruption every 10 months in recent times, and the volcano is currently at a raised alert level. The volcano's magma chamber has seemingly become pressurized to such an extent that it is generating earthquakes as magma intermittently attempts to intrude upwards and break through overlying rock. While this activity could subside without an eruption in 2026, I still think the odds of a fairly harmless eruption are decent this year. When Erta Ale's 2 summit craters collapsed downwards by around 300 feet on July 14, 2025, it marked the end of its approximately 60-year-long continuous eruption. And yet, despite its summit today somewhat resembling Kilauea's immediate post-collapse 2018 summit, I interpret that a high enough magma supply still exists to Erta Ale that magma could soon break through its crater floor and erupt there, resuming one or both of its lava lakes. Whether this might occur this year or sometime in the next 5 years is speculative, but I do not think we have seen the last of Erta Ale's lava lakes quite yet this decade. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.